तेरी दीवानी, सैया, तौबा तौबा एंड मोर. ही इज वन ऑफ द थ्री मेन बिहाइंड दीज कल्ट सॉन्ग. ही इज अ कंपोजर, अ सिंगर एंड अ लिरिसिस्ट. ही इज वन थर्ड ऑफ द बैंड कैलासा. लेट्स वेलकम नरेश कामत, अ ट्रूली यूनिक आर्टिस्ट नोन फॉर हिज डाइवर्स टैलेंट इन द फील्ड ऑफ म्यूजिक. ऑन अ पर्सनल नोट, आई कैन प्राउडली से आई एम वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट फैंस ऑफ कैलासा. And today's podcast is more likely to be a fan interaction. So forgive me for that. And I'm sorry, not sorry. Hi Naresh sir, how are you?
Kaise ho aap? All good. Bahut khush hu. Aapke saath dusri baar mauka mila hai hang out karne ka.
Yes. In fact, aapko yaad hoga pehle jab peak covid mein hum log ne ek chota sa live session kiya tha.
Ji.
So that time ye podcast kuch nahi tha. It was more like an experimental thing.
Haan.
But now this has taken shape and I'm so glad. It's an honor, it's a privilege because I think you know how big a fan I am of you, of Paresh sir, of Kailash sir. Matlab, it's like a dream come true for me while talking to you. Matlab, it really means a lot to me. Matlab,
Thank you so much.
Shayad main express nahi kar pa raha hun, but it does mean a lot to me. So, you know, the first question would be, Teri Diwani, ye jo gana hai, you know, there are few songs in India which really holds value, which is there, which is known by everybody, you know. And Teri Diwani is one of those few songs jo sabko pata hai, sabne suna hai. And aaj shayad 15-20 saal ho gaye us gaane ko release hue. And aaj bhi it is relevant. It is one of the crowd favorites. People listen to it. How did this happen? And did you visualize this happening when you were planning the song?
Yes, good question. But I think, you know, as musicians, inherently, when you come up with something that you like, you are thinking that, chalo yaar, mujhe achha laga hai, to kuch aur, you know, kuch logon ko achha lagega shayad, kyunki mere jaise kaafi log honge shayad, you know. So that is where we started from, basically. You know, you can never hope to know everyone, the crowd's pulse or something, but you can try and interact with them with things you like. And when we made Teri Diwani, we felt that we had something that was, you know, worth something. But also, main aapko bataun ki ye jab gana bana tha, tab hamare paas koi album deal bhi nahi thi. Socho, humne ye gana tab banaya jab humko ek live show karne ka opportunity mila.
Achha.
Delhi mein tha. और राज साहब भी होने वाले थे उस शो में, फिर फ्यूजन बैंड फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान और इंडियन ओशन और कैलाश खेर. तो
अच्छा.
उस वक्त हमको लगा कि यार ये सिर्फ नुसरत फतेह अली खान के गाने गाएंगे तो फिर मतलब ना बात नहीं बनी,
कुछ ओरिजिनल होना चाहिए.
हाँ, होना चाहिए. तो हमने कुछ गाने बनाए जिसमें से एक तेरी दीवानी था. और मुझे याद है जब हम वहां पे दिल्ली के प्रगति में वही था एक्चुअली, तो या श्री फोर्ट, डोंट आई एम फॉरगेटिंग, बट वहां पे हमने जब परफॉर्म किया ये गाना तो लोगों को बहुत अच्छा लगा था. एंड इट वाज अ वेरी रॉ वर्जन ऑफ द सॉन्ग, क्योंकि हम जैम कर रहे थे वैसे.
अच्छा,
ना
अच्छा.
कुछ बना मतलब प्रोडक्शन हुई नहीं.
अच्छा,
तो हमने अरेंज किया था कि हाँ अंतरा मुखड़ा ये होगा और उसके हिसाब से हमने गाना बनाया था. लेकिन उसके बाद एक साल बाद हमको फिर से अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली कुतुब मीनार के फेस्टिवल में परफॉर्म करने का.
अच्छा.
और तब भी एल्बम रिलीज नहीं हुआ था.
अच्छा.
ठीक है. तो वहां पे जब हम गए और ये शो कर रहे थे तो ऑडियंस में से फरमाइशें आने लगी.
अच्छा.
और उनमें से एक था तेरी दीवानी.
ओके.
सो एट दैट पॉइंट हमको लगा कि यार एल्बम गाना रिलीज भी नहीं हुआ है. एक बार हमने दिल्ली में पिछले साल परफॉर्म किया हुआ था और फरमाइशें आ रही है उस गाने की ना, तो वी न्यू दैट वी हैड समथिंग. तो एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम वी थॉट लाइक अगर कुछ होगा या तो मतलब एकदम फ्लॉप होगा या तो बड़ा हो जाएगा कुछ. एंड या द रिजल्ट्स आर फॉर.
तो गट फीलिंग थोड़ा सा भी आया था बिकॉज़ ये सिर्फ बड़ा नहीं हुआ है, ये एक राक्षस हो गया ये गाना, यू नो. मतलब आपको भी पता है सर, आप मॉडर्न बन रहे हो, बट इट इज लाइक इंडिया इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट बिलव्ड सॉन्ग. कभी भी लगा था आप तीनों में से किसी को भी कि ये ऐसा हो सकता है?
देखो, ख्वाब तो हर किसी का होता है और हमारा भी था और हमको भी लगा था यार हम गाने कभी कभी बनाते हैं तो हमको लगता है यार ये ना टॉप हिट होगा, ये होगा, वो होगा, वो तो सबको लगता ही है गानों के बारे में, लेकिन हमेशा, मतलब नॉट हमेशा, एटलीस्ट 80% of the time, 90% of the time, it doesn't happen. Basically, ख्वाब तो सबके होते हैं, and we also hoping that ऐसा कुछ होगा, but we never realized कि it would be, it go to that level, you know. But one thing is there, you know, me and my brother Paresh, we come from a non-Bollywood world of music.
Right.
You know, we used to be in rock music, western music, jazz music, you know, ये blues और वो सब, तो हम वो ज्यादा काफी सुनते थे, एंड फॉर अस बॉलीवुड म्यूजिक वॉज हॉचपॉच एंड यू नो नॉट समथिंग दैट वी काइंड ऑफ रियली कनेक्टेड विद, सो वी ऑलवेज फेल्ट अ सर्टेन डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम बॉलीवुड म्यूजिक इन दैट सेंस, एंड कैलाश एट द सेम टाइम वो भी मतलब सूफी फोक उस दुनिया से आए थे, और उनको भी मतलब कनेक्ट नहीं था बॉलीवुड की म्यूजिक से. So when we started making music together, Bollywood was not part of it.
Right.
So when we made music, हमको लगा यार ये इसमें कुछ depth है. This is not a, you know, चालू चपाती चवन्नी, आज कल आज आया कल निकल गया.
Correct.
Kind of music that we are making.
जी.
So at the very least we thought at least हमारा music शायद classic हो जाए. Yeah, you know, stay for the the next whatever generation or whatever.
Right.
So that is how we try to make music, and I'm glad at some level it has
and
come through.
And this is history. So, ये आप तीनों का जो नाम जो rhyme करता है, like आप दोनों तो brother हो, परेश और नरेश, तो वो समझ आता है. ये कैलाश भी जो rhyme कर गया, was it like a sign from the universe? नहीं तो ऐसा इतना coincidence कैसे हो गया?
यार.
Because जब मैं छोटा था, तो जब हम लोग सुनते थे कैलाश परेश नरेश, पहला थॉट था कि तीनों भाई हैं. कभी आपको ऐसे सुनने में आया था मे बी कि आप तीनों भाई हो या ऐसा कुछ?
देखो नाम से तो ऐसे ही लगता है.
हाँ.
और हम कैलाश कहता भी है कि लोगों को ना, हम तो है ही नरेश परेश कलेश. तो वो तो है ही, बट आई थिंक यू नो इफ यू गो रियली डीप, मतलब पहले के जमाने में जो मतलब 20-30 इयर्स बैक, parents didn't have any imagination. हर घर नाम को भगवान से जोड़ देते थे, तो एश तो आता ही था उसमें. राजेश ना, रमेश, सुरेश, कैलाश, परेश, नरेश आ गए उसमें.
और आप लोग मिले कैसे? आपका ये जो बैंड आप लोग ने फॉर्म किया, was it a very conscious decision कि चलो बैंड फॉर्म करना है, और was it something very luck by chance कि मिले and connect हुआ, vibe मिला and we started?
एक्चुअली जब हम पहले मिले तो बैंड का कोई जिक्र नहीं था, और वहाँ पे मतलब कोई उस हिसाब से मिले ही नहीं थे हम. एक्चुअली ये कैलाश बॉम्बे में आया था, उनके साथ एक उनके स्टूडेंट थे और बिजनेसमैन थे, और उनको उनके लिए एक एल्बम बनानी थी उसके लिए. तो वो जब आए तो उन्होंने एल्बम डील पहले ढूंढा और मिल गया उनको एक एल्बम डील. उस एल्बम के सिलसिले में हम मिले एंड वी स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग कैलाश, और दैट वाज इट. एक्चुअली परेश और मैं उस वक्त शान के लिए लाइव परफॉर्म करते थे, उनके कुछ गाने भी प्रोड्यूस किए थे हमने एल्बम्स के लिए, और उस वक्त परेश और मैंने ये एक ठान लिया था कि हम लाइव नहीं करेंगे और हम स्टूडियोज में मतलब ज्यादा ध्यान लगाएंगे प्रोडक्शन के लिए, कॉम्पोजिशन के लिए, यू नो वी वांटेड टू बी म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर इन दैट सेंस. सो हमने उस वक्त वो ठान लिया था, बट देन वी मेट कैलाश एंड कैलाश के साथ वी स्टार्टेड वर्किंग एंड ऑल, एंड यू नो आई मीन इट्स वी हैड बीन इन द इंडस्ट्री एट दैट पॉइंट, वी न्यू पीपल, वी न्यू द सलीम सुलेमान, गुड फ्रेंड्स ऑफ आवर्स, एंड यू नो देयर वर डिफरेंट पीपल हु वर मेकिंग म्यूजिक. सो we introduced him because of us working with him and making music for him. Hamare doston ne sun liya tha thoda, to Kailash ne Salim ne bhi sun liya tha, to then he started getting calls for singing for ad jingles and ye wo, to uske chakkar mein he also got a film song. And what happened is that after he got the film song and Allah ke bande release hua, he became very famous, everyone came to know who he is, and straight away direct calls came for live shows. और उस वक्त कोई बैंड तो था नहीं।
हाँ।
तो कैलाश हम लोगों को हमेशा बोलता था, यार पता है आप लोगों को नहीं करना है लेकिन प्लीज यार, मैं कितने कॉल्स आ रहे हैं मुझे, हमको तो कुछ करना चाहिए, कुछ हाँ। करना चाहिए ब्रो, हम लोग आप लोग लाइव म्यूजिशियन हो, मैं भी लाइव ही गाता था
हाँ।
तो हम लोग साथ में करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा होगा, मैं बोल रहा हूँ करते हैं करते हैं करते हैं। फाइनली वो शो जो है सरहदों की जुगलबंदी दिल्ली में, जो मैंने आपको कहा था, तो इट वाज टू आर्टिस्ट फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान, टू आर्टिस्ट फ्रॉम इंडिया, एंड दे वर गोइंग टू मीट एंड दे वर गोइंग टू डू अ शो,
राइट,
एंड इट वाज कॉल्ड सरहदों की जुगलबंदी।
अच्छा।
एंड वी वर वेरी एक्साइटेड कि यार दिग्गज आर्टिस्ट आ रहे हैं, सो इट्स अ शो, यू नो, इट्स अ ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शोकेस आवर म्यूजिक एंड देयर आर टैलेंट, सो दैट्स द बर्थ ऑफ कैलाशा, आई गेस।
सो आपको लगता है कि कैलाशा से हम लोग एक और, इट्स वेरी रॉन्ग टू कंपेयर और इवन यू नो मैच, बट हम एक और मे बी सैया या तेरी दीवानी एक और ऐसे एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं इन द न्यू फ्यूचर, समथिंग अनदर कल्ट लाइक?
आई विल से वैसे टाइम्स हैव चेंज्ड, यू नो, न्यू आर्टिस्ट्स हैव कम, न्यू म्यूजिक हैज कम, यू नो, दौर हमेशा बदलते रहता है, सो यू नो, but for us being very true to our music and being you know honest is very important ki you know bahut sare aise hain bollywood mein hamesha hota hai ki na abhi yaar trend aisa hai to aise gaane banao, trend waisa hai to aise gaane banao, to wo I mean film ka hai, you know, people are called to make music by for a movie, not for themselves.
Correct. Yes.
So
yes.
There is a, you know,
ek disconnect sir bhi there.
Not disconnect, but at least there is a certain agenda
for
making music.
Right.
Basically.
Right. Right.
So we don't have that lucky. In the sense, our agenda is to make Kailasa music.
Correct.
But at the same time, it's very important to be honest with yourself and where you are. Are you in the same place as you were when you made Teri Diwani? Or are you here right now, which is a different place, you know? So what are you trying to make? I'm not trying to make another Teri Diwani. I'm trying to make a song that I think makes sense.
Right.
So we are doing that. But at the same time, मैं ये भी बताऊं कि ज़माना बदल गया है और लोगों को सुनने की जो मतलब सुनने का जो माध्यम था, जैसे पहले टेप्स होते थे, सीडीज होते थे, रेडियो होता था, अब काफी बदल चुका है। लोग यूट्यूब पे, इंटरनेट पे, स्ट्रीमिंग सर्विसेज पे सुनते हैं गाने, तो काफी बदल चुका है। तो टू रीच योर ऑडियंस इज अ वेरी टफ, इट्स अ वेरी, इट्स एन आर्ट इन इटसेल्फ।
ओके।
सो बेसिकली आई रिमेम्बर व्हेन वी केम आउट विद तेरी दीवानी एंड सैया एंड ऑल, वी हैड मेड वीडियोस एंड इट यूज्ड टू कम आउट ऑन टीवी।
आई रिमेम्बर, यस, बिल्कुल।
टीवी इज समथिंग, मतलब सब देखते थे
उस समय, यू नो, लाइक अ फैमिली अफेयर, यू नो।
एग्जैक्टली।
करेक्ट।
बट नाउ नॉट सो मच।
करेक्ट।
People don't watch TV. People watch stuff on the internet.
Yes. Right? On their phones primarily. Yeah, exactly.
On the internet. Yes, they go on to YouTube or they'll go somewhere basically. Yes. Instagram or whatever. Mm-hmm. So TV that the whole country which used to sit down and watch is not
correct.
The primary. I don't know if it's not the primary.
Abhi to there's plethora of options for people to browse upon.
Exactly. So your audience bikhar gaya. Like it's, you know, it's in different spaces.
Right.
Before when we released Teri Diwani, the whole country saw it.
Yeah.
Right? Now, not so much.
Yeah.
So, trying to reach your audience, if you don't know that you have made a song, then how will it hit? You understand? Like, karna dur ki baat.
Correct.
They have to first hear you. So, that becomes a very tough job.
Right.
It's very important to try and reach people. And I think that's where today's world is finding it an issue. So we've made a lot of music since then. But because it wasn't released in the same way as Teri Diwani and Saiya, people haven't heard so much of it. You know, we released an album in 2012, which was Rangile. And I thought, mere hisab se, it was amazing. One of my favorite albums.
It's an amazing album. Maine sab gaane sune hain uske. Yes.
So, आप देखो, आप दिलचस्प हो, मतलब दिलचस्पी रखते हो हमारे म्यूजिक में, सो आपने सुना है
जी.
But if you check आम आदमी, they probably wouldn't know.
They probably missed out. Correct.
So basically, that is what we realize. कि music तो है, लेकिन लोगों तक पहुंचना बहुत important होता
है. So how do you ensure that you know music today reaches out to the public? Do you think marketing has a huge role to play with that? But again, you know, I have also heard from a lot of creative people, artists, that they're not too fond of marketing because it's a very technical and a strategy game, whereas creating music is, you know, it's something which is like ek dil ka kaam hai aur ek dimag ka kaam hai. So aap kaise dono ko bifurcate karte ho and kya bahut zaruri hai karna, and like can you skip it if you need?
See, I think zaruri matlab it's a necessity, you know, it's not like whether you want it or you don't want it. I think it is imperative. And that's an art, I said. That's an art and it's a job. And people, you have experts who study the market and figure out how to do this.
Right.
So it is definitely important, you know. And yeah, of course, we make music. Doesn't mean we know how to sell it exactly to people. So we need help as far as all that goes. But also, it's an experiment right now. Matlab, there are, you know, big companies like T-Series, whose music now is not selling as much. Their YouTube songs are not selling as much. So they are also looking at new ways because streaming has come in and that has changed the game. So it is always an ever-changing scenario and you need to study it. And you need people who know how to do this to be involved, to be able to do, you know, market it. So I think talmel hota hai. So you need people to come in and help you, you know, sell it. I think it's very important. And a lot of people hate it because, you know, it's not done right. Mostly it's not done right. They get the wrong people into the thing.
Yes,
and then they realize, yaar, kya kiya humne? Achha gana banaya tha, dil se banaya tha, lekin unhone yaar to yaar, you know, lassi kar diya. So basically it's that. I think you have to find the right people. And I don't know. I don't have all the answers, but we are going to try.
So you mentioned Bollywood. Being a fan and a listener of your music, you know, I also see, like, personally mere ko bolenge to main bolunga hai director producer ko aap log ko hi lena chahiye as musicians for their film. But as you said, Bollywood music has again evolved over the years. You know, personally I'm not a huge fan of it right now. Pehle 90s and 2000s mein to fir bhi sunne ko dil karta tha, to matlab I personally don't like it. So has it ever happened to you, you know, that a film or a web series has been offered to you guys or you personally, you know, and somehow the wavelength did not match or the frequency did not match and you did not end up doing it? Because it's very different from the music that you believe in versus the music what they're asking you to make.
Yeah, I mean, see, the thing is, I don't think it's ever happened that, you know, people have come to me or us to make music for something and it didn't work out.
Okay.
It always did work out, but how much of it is me?
Exactly.
How much of it is us?
Exactly. Yes.
You know,
yes.
Because someone else has asked it and they want it in a certain scenario and they want a certain style of music or, you know, whatever. And even though they've come to us thinking it's not exactly us, right? So, humko unke liye banana pada. You know, so when we did Chandni Chowk to China as Kailash Paresh Naresh, we did that, some of the songs in it. It wasn't really Kailash. But we tried to add a little of our flavor into it and try and, you know, make it work for the film and stuff like that. And I will say one thing, ki we have managed to make that music still Kailasa because we performed a couple of the songs live with us, like Chakland Day. We perform it live and, you know, it really works for the audience and in that sense. So it's, you know, nothing, everything doesn't fit like a glove. You have to compromise and you have to make adjustments and stuff. And the people who really do that well are the ones who actually prosper.
Right. So, I remember Naseer saab ne ek bar kaha tha ki main kuch filmein karta hoon pet ke liye aur kuch filmein main karta hoon dil ke liye. So, is doing Bollywood music something like that? You know, kuch hota hai pet ke liye, kuch hota hai dil ke liye.
Dekho, haan. Hota bhi hai. I don't know. I can't talk for like all the other, you know, diggaj music directors. The Rehmans and Preetams and stuff like that. Unhone to itna, matlab, pet to bhar gaya, bahut pehle bhar gaya. Phir bhi kar rahe hain. But, you know, it is like, kya bolenge? It's like, it is also a drug in that sense. Aapne gaane banaye, hit ho gaya, logon ko bahut pasand aa gaya. Abhi soch rahe hain, yaar, abhi aap kal kya banaoge, kya naya kya niklega? Aur aapko bhi wo challenge lag raha hai ki humko karna hai music, you know? So I think it's a little of all that, you know. It's basically, if you have success in doing something and then you want to do it more,
right?
You know, so it's not just about making money or, you know, it's also about success and, you know, feeling good about yourself, I guess.
See, मेरे को कभी कभी लगता है ना that even the audience they sometimes, like, for example, the maybe people know you for, say, Chandni Chowk to China, mein apne chaklein de kiya tha, but they don't know that you have huge songs, you have better songs in your kitty, you know, which is perhaps 10 times more dynamic and beautiful than that one. But they don't give you credit for that because they have not listened to you or whatever. For example, even Shilpa Rao, jiske saath aapne kaam kiya tha haal hi mein, you know, usme bhi Shilpa Rao recently got the recognition last couple of years with, I think, Pathaan and unhone jaha pe gaana kiya. Lekin, she's a great singer, you know, she's a proper classical singer and some of the songs that she has sung previously, even in Manmarzi and all of that.
Yes.
Uske liye unko kabhi bhi wo due nahi mila, even for the song that you have done, it's such a wonderful song. बट वो ड्यू नहीं मिला जो उनको ये पठान और इससे मिला जवान से. हालांकि आई डोंट थिंक इट वाज दैट ग्रेट अ सॉन्ग, सो डू यू टू से ऑन दैट, बिकॉज़ जिस पे उतना डिजर्विंग नहीं होता, अगेन इट्स पर्सनली माय ओपिनियन, नहीं होता उसको लोग एकदम चढ़ा देते हैं, जो एक्चुअली होता है वो कहीं ना कहीं खो जाता
है. सी देखो, व्हाट म्यूजिक इज सब्जेक्टिव.
Exactly.
You know,
yeah.
What do you think is Hira, someone else will think is Kuda.
Correct.
So basically,
correct.
You cannot put a pinpoint it. You know, you can't put a finger on it. Basically, so it's like, you know, aapke liye jo acha hai, kisi aur ke liye bura hai. So basically, commercial songs, of course, they have the kind of marketing. फिल्म की बजट है वो, मतलब इतने लोगों तक पहुंचती है, तो फिर उनको सुनने को मिलता है तभी उनको अच्छा या बुरा लगेगा ना. सुना ही नहीं है तो अच्छा बुरा क्या लगे,
राइट?
नो, सो बेसिकली दैट्स द पावर ऑफ बिग बजट मूवीज एंड मार्केटिंग, बिकॉज मतलब खज्जल से खज्जल गाना या बहुत अच्छा गाना सभी लोगों तक पहुंचता है, तभी तो वो जाके मतलब अच्छा लगे या बुरा लगे होता है उसका.
एंड व्हाट वाज योर पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ वर्किंग विद शिल्पा?
You see, I always loved her voice. I had heard her voice, one of her songs which she has sung for Amit Trivedi. It was Iklaw. It was in a very, bahut pehle ki film hai, Aamir karke, I think.
I think Rajiv Khandelwal was there.
Yes. Same film. And that song really touched me, you know. And again, you know, that's a song ki bahut sare logon ne shayad suna nahi hai.
Correct.
But I really love that song and it always is in my head. So when I thought of this song and I, in fact, dhun mujhe aise aayi ki matlab maine unki awaaz mein dhun bana di. You know what I'm saying? So I couldn't think of someone else singing the song. And then, of course, it was a pleasure to work with her because she is also very honest when it comes to singing. Her voice is very honest, you know. It's not put on, basically. So it really worked because the magic she did in that song was amazing, you know. So and that is what I really treasure, you know, the genuineness of the artist and the honesty with which they sing and the heart that comes out. You know, there's no pretense,
right?
And I think that song required that. So basically, Savariya was born because of this.
Right. So, was it a decision which you took in your early years, maybe when you were a teenager, that you want to be a musician, or was it something which happened later during your life?
Actually, क्या था ना, बचपन से ही म्यूजिक तो बहुत अच्छा लगता था, हम लोग गाने सीखते थे, सुनते थे ये वो. लेकिन I realized कि यार मेरे दोस्तों में से मुझे धुन पकड़ने में बहुत आसानी होती थी.
अच्छा.
दोस्तों को इतनी जल्दी धुन पकड़ने में नहीं होता. अच्छा. मतलब गाने को गाना, मतलब बेसुरा गाते थे लोग. तो मैं भी सोचा था ये बेसुरा कैसे गा रहा है यार, तो ठीक आ रहा है. यू नो दैट स्मॉल थिंग व्हेन यू वर अ किड मेड मी रियलाइज यार कुछ तो है कि मुझे ये आसानी से पकड़ने में आ रहा है, बाकियों को नहीं हो रहा. So then, you know, you start getting more into it. More deeper and deeper. And I already had an elder brother. So basically your elder brother is like your hero when you're a child. Uh-huh. So, you know, he was already into music and he was really into music. So I also got into it with him. And, you know, before we knew how to play an instrument, we already had written songs. Uh-huh. English mein the gaane, uh-huh. Lekin phir bhi gaane humne banaye the. And we were very interested in trying to, you know, record the songs. So घर पे एक डबल टेप डेक, आप मुझे पता नहीं आपकी उम्र क्या है, बट एक डबल टेप डेक होता था, सीडी प्लेयर ऊपर होता था. तो एक टेप प्लेयर होता था, दूसरा रिकॉर्ड होता था. तो एक हम लोग एक टेप को रिकॉर्डर में डालते थे और फिर टेबल पे बीट बनाते थे और रिकॉर्ड कर लेते थे, ठीक है। फिर वो टेप हम टेप प्लेयर में डालते थे, नया टेप रिकॉर्डर में डालते थे, बीट के साथ हम गाते थे, एंड वी शुड रिकॉर्ड दैट। सो वी वर वेरी इंटरेस्टेड इन द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग अ सॉन्ग, रिकॉर्डिंग इट एंड यू नो हैविंग इट एज आवर ओन सॉन्ग। तो इमेजिन व्हेन यू आर अ चाइल्ड इन स्कूल, व्हेन यू आर इन द 8th स्टैंडर्ड, यू वांट टू डू ऑल दिस,
राइट।
So by the time we got into college, it was like, yeah, I was so deep into music.
There was no other option anymore. And exactly. Your parents were very cool with it, family?
See, I mean, they weren't really actually. They were very scared. Like any other parent would be. Ki yaar, isme kya, agar wo us field mein nahi hai, pehle se. So they're always apprehensive, na, yaar, paise kaise kamaoge? Kya tum kya, matlab, shaadiyon mein gaoge? Kya karoge? तो उनको पता नहीं था शादियों में कितने पैसे होते
हैं।
बिलियन डॉलर इंडस्ट्री, बट या एट दैट पॉइंट यू नो दैट वाज द होल थॉट प्रोसेस। सो दे वर ऑफ कोर्स स्केयर्ड, बट यार ना आई वाज सो बैड एट एवरीथिंग एल्स कि यार कोई और कोई चारा नहीं था, यू नो, से चलो करो। No, so that's how we got into music, and of course they could see that we were dedicated. We were not avaras, you know, we're not going out and partying and hanging out and saying I'm a musician. 10-10 ghante hum log practice karte the. So you know, it was, we were very into it. It is just that they were scared. कि यार इतना मतलब मेहनत कर रहा है बेचारा, you know, कि पैसे क्या कमाएगा?
Right.
That is overly.
And who are the like who are your top three artists that you really admired while growing up and you look up to them?
Wow. Okay. So. That's a tough one. I mean, you know, there wasn't like, they weren't like just one. I mean, I would
That's
say.
That's why I said three. You can say five.
See, I will say one thing. My brother was a big influence on me.
Wow.
Very big. Because at the same, he was only like around 3-4 years older than me.
Gotcha.
So, but I used to see how dedicated he was, how into it he was, and how his, how like, you know, in tune with music he was. Matlab, usne to पहले पहले जो कॉर्ड्स होते हैं गिटार में उसने खुद को सिखाया सुन सुन के। सो बेसिकली डिडंट नो द नेम ऑफ द कॉर्ड्स वर एंड लाइक, बट देन स्लोली स्लोली केम टू नो दैट दीज आर कॉर्ड्स एंड देयर नेम्स। सो यू नो इट्स अ वेरी नेचुरल इंस्टिंक्ट फॉर म्यूजिक दैट ही हैड, एंड ही वाज, एंड यू नो बिकॉज़ ऑफ दैट ही वाज वेरी इन्फ्लुएंशियल एंड आई रियली लुक्ड अप टू हिम, एंड लाइक आई वुड से दैट माय ब्रदर वाज प्रोबब्ली माय फॉरमोस्ट लाइक इन्फ्लुएंस एज़ फार एज़ म्यूजिक गोस बेसिकली। Then there was a lot of other people growing up, but I would say Zakir Hussain.
Okay.
You know, because he was such a, you know, he was virtuoso.
Still is.
Still is. You know, he's a virtuoso in his instrument, and at the same time, humble and, you know, very, he was so, welcoming and very like, yeah, you know, very nice person.
I've heard that about
so him. Basically, yes. That I saw that and I really like thought like, you know, this is someone I want to be, you know, at least my ideals were that, you know, that I want to be something like this, you know. So he was one of my influences that way, I would say. Kishore Kumar was there because he was such a so natural and so happy and, you know, always trying to learn new things. उन्होंने जब शुरुआत की थी back in the day in black and white films, तब से गा रहे थे, and like, you know, how he came to modern times and how he changed his styles of singing and, you know, got into it and like, you know, adjusted with the times or whatever and did it so flawlessly, you know. So it was big influence for me.
I've read in a lot of places that he was never professionally trained as well. So is it like a true thing? Are you aware of that?
I would say yes, because he didn't do classical training as, you know,
right. As Rafi Saab ne jaise
kiya. Yeah, exactly. But see, the thing is, talent to har kisi mein. Bahut sare aise hain Eklavya. मैं कहता हूँ, यू नो, हीरे हैं, मतलब दे हैव टैलेंट एंड यू नो दे डू देयर ओन थिंग बिकॉज दे लिसन टू व्हाट्स हैपनिंग एंड यू नो ट्राइन फ्रॉम इमिटेशन टू रियल आर्ट दे गेट इनटू इट लेटर ऑन इन लाइफ, नॉट लाइक द अदर पीपल, जैसे आपने बताया मोहम्मद रफी साहब हु वाज इमेंसली टैलेंटेड ऑफ कोर्स एंड वेंट थ्रू द राइट चैनल्स एंड केम इनटू इट। सो इट्स लाइक इट्स नॉट अबाउट exactly how you've come, is like, you know,
right,
where you are, you know, and what you do with it, basically. Talent is very important, and just because they haven't come through the classical training and all, right, doesn't mean unhone mehnat nahi ki.
Right.
You know, right. So it's you're gifted, I would say.
How easy or difficult is it to make your mark in the Hindi film industry as a musician if you don't have a godfather or godmother?
See, I'll say one thing. If you are really, truly talented and you are also, nothing can stop.
Right.
Nothing, especially in music. I would say in most things, but like in music, for sure. Music, you know, you can't, it has less of nepotism.
Right. Okay.
Because if your son or daughter can't sing well, that's as far as they'll go. You know? Right. Whereas in acting, even if they don't act well, 10-15 film de do unko, put them in the right context and suddenly the film becomes a hit. Kisi na kisi ko achha lag jayega. You know? So you can get away with it. But gana and, you know, like singing and singing in tune and dhune, it's like a talent very few people have.
Right.
And not everyone has it. And you can straight away make out what if someone's good or bad in that sense, you know. So
also, like, independent musicians, you know, in the West, they earn a lot more than independent musicians in India. How true or false is this statement? And if it is true, then why so?
It is true, in my opinion, because I will say one thing. Maine dekha hai West mein, especially in, like, you know, America, Europe, basically.
Okay.
There, it's streamlined. It's a business. That's so true. It's very streamlined. You have people who might not have come on radio at all or in the public spectrum, but they have a loyal fan following. And the people come for their live performances. They, like, follow them. And, you know, it's a very professional, independent scene. Whereas in India, the independent scene is... it's a make-believe kind of scene. It's not a truly independent scene because unfortunately in India, the real people making money are the people who are organizing events, not the artists themselves.
Right.
So, you know, it's the event organizer or the, promoter. Those are the people making the real money.
Right.
So, you know, it's unfortunate, but that's how it is. So basically, people who go for live events and see artists and stuff like that, they aren't true followers, I would say. Because yahan pe independent scene mein, haan, kuch log to hai, of course, definitely, you know, that come and see. But it's like, agar kal ko koi artist show aapko dekhna tha, unko nikal ke koi naya artist dal diya, aap phir bhi jaoge dekh. That's how it is in the independent scene. Because it's a social scene more than it is an pure musical event. So you know that, you know, like-minded people will come. Yaar, kuch ladkiyan aayengi, ye hoga, ye hoga. Toh fana karke aap jaoge. Zaroor jaoge. Maybe you will not like the music, but you will go for that event. So that is what basically happens in India. So the artist doesn't get too much money from it and they can't sustain themselves because of this situation. There are, having said that, I can't, it's not 100% that way.
They cannot generalize it, but that's the overall scene you're saying.
Yeah, overall scene, that's what it is. Basically, the artists don't call the shots. Whereas abroad, the following for some for the artists are so strong.
Yeah,
that right. Basically, they do call the shots. And
they dictate,
you know, so, you know, one. Of course, unknown artists have to still toe the line and follow it. And I'm not saying that the promoters, are, they don't make money. I'm sure they make a lot of money, probably more. But because of the fact that the artists have loyal fan following and people come for musical events, not just a social scene,
right.
They have a lot more say in what how much money they get and all that stuff. So I think there it's a independent scene because of the money being independently provided out there. Out here, you need sponsorships, you need other things, people to come in. Promoters will not pay you the money because, you know, they'll say, yaar, you know, we sold beverages and that's how we made money. You know, the ticket sales were not that much, this and that. So people cannot earn a living just out of independent music money, you know. So unfortunately, that's the scene. And yeah, we have to try and make it better for sure.
On a lighter note, one of your again very popular songs, "Sahiya," you know, वो किसी के ब्रेकअप के टाइम पे लिखा गया इतना दर्द है उस गाने
में. नहीं, एक्चुअली "सहिया" तो यार बहुत मीठा सा प्यारा सा गाना है. तो इतना दर्द नहीं है, बट इट्स लाइक यू नो प्यार है उसमें. सो दर्द होगा तो तेरी दीवानी में हो सकता है.
परसेप्शन द वे यू लुक एट
थिंग्स. या एक्जेक्टली. सो बट
टॉक अस थ्रू दैट सॉन्ग. हाउ डिड दैट कम अबाउट? वो कैसे बना
है? "सहिया" सी इट्स lyrics have been written by Kailash
for sure,
basically. And I wouldn't say Kailash is a romantic in that sense. Yeah. But you know, when he is thinking of music, of love or anything, he's thinking of it in a very pure sense. Unki taleem jo hai in sufi gaano se hi bani. So he knows the kind of, you know, depth that's there in sufi writings, and you know, so his influences came from there. And as far as the music goes, as I told you, it's all about feel. It's all about what you feel. हम लोग कितनी बार सोचते यार इस कॉर्ड पे ऐसे ऐसे करके हम गाना बनाएंगे, होता ही नहीं है, फेंक देते हैं हम.
करेक्ट.
बट जब कुछ सुनते हैं तो अंदर से आता है, नहीं नहीं नहीं, अरे यार नहीं नहीं, ये जाए, अच्छा ये हो, एंड देन यू नो रिकॉर्ड कर, रिकॉर्ड भूल जाएंगे रिकॉर्ड कर. And then you have suddenly something there, you know? Right. And then you start thinking over it over the week.
Right.
And then you get back and then you see, okay, yeah, isme kuch tha yaar. Then we can develop it, you know, that way. So it's a lot of emotional feel that comes into making music and songs come out, you know? So I wouldn't say that we don't do that for songs which are not hit.
Uh-huh.
We do that for those also. But sometimes, you know, things come up that, you know, like just have that quality in them. And I think that's "Sahiya" is one of those songs.
Right. If you have to maybe collaborate with one artist, living or dead, you know, who would that be?
Wow. One artist, living or dead. Wow. I would...
I think you're too content with whatever's happening with Kailash. I'm sure, yeah, which is great, I think.
There is a plethora of artists that we would like to work with. If you had to see one person, yeah, fir, you know.
Again, ab chaar paanch bol do.
Like, this is just me and my wishful thinking bucket list. I would love to work with the remaining Beatles, like Paul McCartney or something. That would be amazing to make a song with them, basically. Then I would love to work with... Abhida Parveen, so I would love to work with her. And
greatly. My God, amazing. Yeah. Kya choice.
The classics, yeah. You know, the people that like, yeah, really, huh. I would have loved to work with Nusrat Saab if he was alive, at, you know, right now. But yeah, these are the people I would love to work with. Rehman also. Yeah. I love his style of music, his thinking, and... it would be a pleasure, but of course, you know, all visual thinking.
Any memorable incident on stage? Maybe a funny one. Something maybe kuch toot gaya ho, ya kuch jhagda ho gaya ho off backstage. Yeah, some memorable incident from a live show.
Memorable incident. It's always been funny things. Actually, these are the early days that we used to do shows, and Kailash had just started becoming famous, and I remember this one time there was, we had landed up in, I think, Udaipur airport or Jodhpur airport, I'm not sure. And kuch fans aa gaye the unke, "Kailash ji, aap humare saath aayye, humne to gaadi aapke liye li hai, aayye aap humare saath." So Kailash went with those people, and we were also wondering, unke saath kyun gaya, or whatever, you know, he had kuch. उन्होंने उनके लिए कुछ गाया था पहले, सो यू नो यू न्यू देम फ्रॉम बिफोर, सो ओके चलो ठीक है. तो हम लोग पहुंच गए वहां पे, और ये शो जो हम कर रहे थे ये पुलिस फोर्स के लिए थी वहां पे.
अच्छा.
और बहुत सारे पुलिस ऑफिसर्स प्लेन क्लोज में थे, यू नो, उनका अपना इवेंट है बेसिकली. एंड देयर वाज दिस वन मेन पुलिस ऑफिसर हु वाज लाइक अ बिग मैन एंड एवरीवन रिस्पेक्टेड, ही वाज इन प्लेन क्लोज. इन ये जो उनके साथ गए थे उनको पता नहीं था, और वो मतलब उनकी बॉडी गार्ड बन के घूम रहे थे उनके साथ. तो after the show, एक बंदे ने आके इस पुलिस ऑफिसर को धक्का दे दिया. कैलाश कैलाश ने नहीं भैया मत करना नहीं. जो उसको मार पड़ी उसके बाद बापे कैलाश वाज विजिबली डिस्ट्रॉयड एट दैट टाइम. सो दैट वाज वन वेरी फनी इंसिडेंट दैट वी सॉ एंड कैलाश वाज लाइक मैं क्या करूं मैं बीच में फंस गया था यार.
सम यू नो कभी ऐसा हुआ है कि ऑर्गेनाइजर्स या क्राउड से कुछ एब्सर्ड डिमांड्स आ गए हैं ड्यूरिंग अ लाइव शो?
एब्सर्ड अभी पीपल ऑलवेज हैव यू नो बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं फिल्म के गाने पूछते हैं. दे डोंट इवन नो दैट इट्स नॉट सम बाय अस. वी डोंट नो व्हाट इट इज.
हाउ डू यू रिएक्ट टू दैट?
आई मीन जस्ट लाफ इट ऑफ. क्या बोल रही है ना,
अंदर कुछ गाली वाली तो आता होगा?
नहीं नहीं अभी मतलब कितने सारे शोज किए हैं पता है लोग इतना मतलब एकदम कुछ लोग तो बेवकूफ होते हैं कुछ लोग अनजान होते हैं. मतलब देयर हार्ट इज इन द राइट प्लेस. इट्स ओके.
हाउ इज कैलाश खेर एज अ पर्सन टू बी अराउंड? Not as a singer, not as a artist, just as a friend, as a band member, as a colleague.
That way he always he hears you out all the time. He will hear you out and he's doesn't have those kind of airs or anything like that. I would say that. He's still humble in that sense, you know, very friendly and jovial. But of course, you know, as people we are very different. You know, my value systems are different. I am not traditional in that sense. Right. He is a little lot more traditional in that sense. So
yes,
but you know, I mean, the thing is we have learned to be respectful of each other's worlds and opinions, and you know, and we know that some things work, some things don't, I guess. You know? So we aren't the best of friends in that sense, but we are musical brothers for sure.
I think that's the beautiful thing about life.
Yeah.
Sir, we have this section called straight or twisted. Okay. There are about 7-8 sentences jo main aapko bolunga. Aapko bolna hai wo straight hai ya twisted hai. Straight matlab that's true. Twisted matlab usme kuch truth hai, kuch jhoot hai. Maybe in the middle, the gray areas basically.
Okay.
Right. So are you ready, sir?
All right.
Music composers often don't receive the respect they deserve. Straight ya twisted?
Twisted.
You can't improve your vocal range.
Twisted.
Some singers lip sync during live performances instead of singing in their own voice.
Straight.
All singing reality shows are fake.
Twisted.
Rap is not a form of music.
Twisted.
Singers don't get paid for singing in movies.
Twisted.
Anuv Jain, Ritviz, Tony Kakkar, they are not versatile musicians.
Twisted.
Independent bands, artists are much better than the Bollywood musicians and band singers.
Twisted.
Naresh sir, it was a pleasure having you with us on Twisted Truths and thank you so much for coming here.
My pleasure.
I wish you the best of everything. Keep making amazing music. So that it's
thank you
good
so
for
much.
Me and for everybody.
Well, I would say the same. I wish you all the best. And I can see you've you know, notched up all your production since the last interview that we did.
I wish
you all the best and hope you find all the success.
Thank you so much. And we'll have a part 2 again soon.
Of course.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.